Good afternoon. I'm going to present the results of the project entitled Reducing Student Risk in the Laboratory Protocol Assessment. The main objectives of this work was to evaluate the work methodology proposed for a teaching laboratory that was designed to reduce the risk associated with the work of students in the laboratory. This design established protocols for action with the help of mobile technology. These protocols seek to enable students to incorporate preventive attitudes to their work routines in order to minimize the risk associated with their own work in the laboratory and to include safety regulation connected with the labels of the chemical reactants they are being handling. Working in a laboratory involves a series of risks of very, very, very varied origin and consequences, which are related, among other parameters, to the chemical products being handled. These chemical products are often very dangerous, but also it's true that it's used only in small amounts and not continuously. Students are largely unaware of the risk that the use of these reactants have, so this often use a way to work in the laboratory that can be dangerous for them. So we consider it necessary for students to learn the need for avoiding risk and to that contribute to their own safety, helping them to establish a work protocol of which the evaluation of risks and their prevention are an essential part. Technology gives us the opportunity of using technological resources during our daily task. With this proposal, we aim to develop in our students the skill of risk prevention in laboratories by using ICT. In this experiment, we use QR codes because QR codes can contain a lot of varied information and they are used to consult. We drawn up three type of codes because due to the big amount of information, all the information can be encoded in one QR code. The black one code contains the basic or the most important, the minimal information about risk and can be consulted without access to the internet. The blue one code contains the complete security card or the safety card and can be consulted in HTML format, and it was easily read in any mobile device regardless the size of the screen. The red code allows the downloading of the complete card in PDF format, so the students can consult the safety card the safety card afterwards. A user's guide was drawn up for the correct reading of the QR codes, indicating the color of the different codes and the different programs to read the QR codes depending on the different platforms. A table with the most important risk associated with the different reactants was also included. Previous to start the laboratory classrooms, the teacher has held a previous session where the safety cards, the safety practices, the labeling and the symbols regarding the security of the reactant were explained. And in this initial session, a short questionnaire was handed out to the students to know the characteristic of the students, and the variables that were included was this, this one. Before each session of laboratory, the reactants were put together in a different place together with the different codes, and the teacher explained that they must consult the codes before to take each reactant and ask to each group if they know how to handle each reactant. the satisfaction of the students and the acquiring of the prevention of risk skill was analyzed. To evaluate the satisfaction of the students, a satisfaction questionnaire was set to the students with these six questions that was evaluated in a Likert type scale. To know if the students have acquired the prevention risk skill, a pretest and a post-test was set to the students. The pretest was set the first day of the laboratory practices, and the post-test set via the Moodle platform. This test had 25 questions with multiple choice. These 25 questions can be divided in two blocks, one block related to first aid and another block related to risk identification. The result showed that regarding the initial student questionnaire showed that most of the students have made laboratory practice before, almost 97%. A high percentage of the students have received information about safety standards and about the security that there are available in the laboratories, such to how to act when they have a trouble in the ears, eyes, or something like that. However, only 46% have been trained on science labs containing chemical reagents, and only 13% have received previous notion about first aid. Regarding pre and post test, the initial marks were about 5% in the whole test. However, if the different blocks are observed separately, we can see that the first... The marks in the first aid block... The first aid block were lower than the risk identification block. The post-test marks show a significant increase both in the media, in the average mark, and in the marks obtained in the two blocks separately. The most important increase was in the first aid block, although a huge dispersal of the data was also observed. A total of 30 students complete both questionnaires, and we apply the student test to check if the differences were statistically significant, and the differences were significant in all cases. It should be taken into account that the student show interest for QR codes and to download the different programs. However, they systematically forgot to check the risk associated with the reactants, even if they have to move to another place to take the bottles and to carry to the workplace. And the teacher has to remind them constantly that they should check the safety cast and safety levels. However, once they were reminded, they show interest and ask to the teacher about the safety subject. The student satisfaction questionnaire showed that the information supplied by supplied on laboratory safety will be used to in the future, and all university subjects involving laboratory practice sessions should include work on notion of safety. However, although they find useful the QR codes, they find that there are more they tend to use the teacher explanation more than QR codes to know about safety in question. As a conclusion, we observed that this experiment shows us the students do not perceive the need for extreme caution when working with chemical reactants. Students are absolutely dependent on the information supplied them by their teacher in this regard. The main result hoped for was that the students will be able to include in their work routines a preventive action protocol to minimize the risk associated with laboratory work. The experiment carried out has shown the incorporation of these routines by the students will need time. We want to thank the University of Salamanca for supporting this project.